Hi, welcome to Crossfader. My name is Jamie Hartley, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to be helping out the beginner DJs that are just starting out. One of the most important things every beginner DJ needs to learn is about levels in music, and in particular, three important ways to control the levels on your piece of DJ equipment, whether it be a controller, a mixer, an all-in-one unit, it doesn't matter. I'm going to explain how to use the different level controls on your mixer or controller, and in particular, why it's important to use them when you're mixing between different songs. Please remember, if you enjoy this tutorial, to like, comment, share, subscribe, and do all that good stuff to help us keep making more videos just like this one. In this tutorial, I'm using the Pioneer DDJ SB3 with Serato DJ Lite, but what you're about to learn can be applied to pretty much any DJ setup. I'm using an entry-level controller because a lot of beginner DJs will start off with something like this. And if you can understand these principles on something like this piece of equipment, then you can translate it across anything more advanced very easily. There are three things we need to be aware of when it comes to levels on a DJ mixer or DJ controller. First of all, we have the channel levels, which are here and here. We have the trim controls, which might be called gain controls on different pieces of equipment. And these are the top two knobs, usually above the EQs. And we also have a master level on this controller. It's in the center here. You might hear my voice dipping up and down because I'm recording through the master level out. What we need to do is set these up correctly so that your mix sounds nice and consistent, the levels sound nice and consistent throughout, and that you're not damaging the quality of the audio coming out of the controller and into your speakers. You're not getting a distorted version. So first of all, we can turn all of them down. Now, I'm not going to turn the master level down because otherwise you won't be able to hear me speak. But usually master levels, you can see here, there's a dark bar. And I've just set it just at the start of that dark bar. Now that is a kind of an indicator on a lot of Pioneer products anyway, that if you go into there, you're probably going to start distorting the music. It's not always the case, but if you sit it just at the start of this section, then it's going to be a nice level. You can always go quieter, but try not to go too much louder than that. Then what we can do is play some audio. So I've got a track loaded on the left-hand side, and if we play it, we need to look at this channel level. Nothing's going to happen to start with because we've got the trim control down. But as we bring that up, you'll notice that the visual meter starts to appear. And if I go really high, it suddenly just sits and we have green, yellow or orange, and then red. Now the aim of this is to try and have the track's audio sitting out of the red. You don't want it to be sat in the red here. You want it a bit lower. Green is good. Yellow is a warning sign. It's saying just be careful. And red is stay out. So if we start bringing the trim level back down, what we want is, so in the main part of the track, it's just jumping up and down into the yellow or the orange. Now this is set on this track at about that position. So what are we, about 10 o'clock roughly? Let's go back to the main part of the song and then bring the channel fader up. So this is realistically how loud we can have this song on this controller. Now, why is this important? Well, first of all, you need to understand that the trim controls or the gain controls change what is coming into the unit. So you can balance two different songs. They may have been produced at slightly different levels or different volumes, and you can use this trim control to then make sure that both tracks sit at the same level, even when both faders are up and you're mixing between them. If you have them just both set exactly the same, imagine this song is produced a little bit quieter, it won't stand out as well in the mix. Also, imagine it's maybe produced a bit louder, you might need to then drop the trim or the gain down slightly. And that's how you can use the input gains to balance the two songs that you're mixing. Now, you can use these channel level VU meters to almost preview what the levels are going to be like when you get into the mix. So if this song's playing and you're queuing up your next song ready, I can now see in the intro of this song, we're only hitting sort of the greens where the trim level is. Now that might work quite nicely because I want to bring the song in at a quieter volume, but let's just look, if I turn this up slightly, suddenly it jumps into the yellows and it is now hitting a similar volume, a little bit louder maybe,
a similar volume to the opposite side. So if I were to put both tracks up, obviously that's not where you would want to mix them, but you can hear the actual level of the music sounds very similar. You'll notice, however, that the trim on this side is just ever so slightly higher than the trim on that side. This all just comes down to using these aids, like the channel level VU meters, listening with your ears. Remember, you can use your headphones to preview the songs. You could even just use the master cue, if you have that on your controller, to listen to what it would sound like out loud in the master. So as you mix, you can listen to a direct source in your headphones what is coming out of the speakers. Now, if I were to mix these two tracks together, I always think it's a good habit to turn down the trim just a bit lower than its peak level before mixing it in. I'm not going to use any EQs in this example that comes next, and you would use EQs when mixing, but just to get your levels right and to understand levels, what we need to do is I usually turn down the trim a bit more than is needed. So if this song's playing and I'm going to mix the next one in on the next phrase, which is the next section of music, I would bring the trim down. After I press play, just use the VU meter and use my headphones to make sure it's lower than its peak level, which is just below the red rim. 4, 3, 2, 1, and so now you can see on the VU meter that it's a lot lower. So I could bring this in, and it doesn't sound overpowering or overbearing. I then have room to bring the trim up. And I've brought the trim up to hit that similar level, which is just below the reds. So now it's a consistent level throughout the mix. Now, if I didn't bring that trim down, it would sound something like this. Just waiting for the next phrase, I'll go here. If I didn't bring the trim down and I fade it in, it's very overpowering in the mix. Bring the trim down, and it can sound a lot cleaner. So this isn't a full tutorial on how to mix. I just want, as a beginner DJ, for you to understand that there are three different levels in play here. Channel levels, trim levels, and master level. The master level is the overall level that comes out of the speaker. So once you have that set, especially if you're just playing at home, you probably won't need to touch that. If you're playing in a nightclub or with a crowd in front of you, then the more people you have there, the more they're going to soak up the music. So the more you would maybe want to turn this master level up throughout the night, you know, if a club gets busier, for example. But the trims or gains are very important, and as well as the channel faders. Now, if you're a DJ that wants to mix very long mixes, then you wouldn't need to play with the trims as much, because you can start fading the channel fader in and you can balance the levels between the channel faders here. However, I would always just remember this. You always want the level to stay consistent throughout your mix. So the last thing you want to do is to double the volume of the source coming out to the speakers. If everything is left at full volume and you bring a second channel in, it's basically going to double the audio volume. So you always want one song to be slightly louder than the other. And there's a point in the mix where you will swap those levels over so it's still only hitting a peak level. But by using the trims and eventually the EQs, you can then swap the energy level over and swap the levels of the music so that the next song becomes the peak song and the other one's in the background. It's a fine line to dance around, but just be aware of those trims. They're very much overlooked a lot of the time. New DJs will probably just leave them and not touch them. Be aware of them and make sure you play around with them. Last thing to bear in mind is in Serato DJ, for example, there are also other levels within the software. So as standard, it's set up pretty well, but if you're playing a song and this here, this is another trim control, but it's within the software itself. If this, you've knocked it right up here, you see again, it's sat in the reds. And even if I bring this down, I'm still getting a distorted version of the song from the software. Now, there is a setting in Serato DJ. If you go in the gear icon for both Serato DJ Lite and Pro and use auto gain here in DJ preferences, when you next load a song, you'll notice that, well, it's done it automatically, but it's dropped this input gain down. If I load it in again, and you'll notice it drops it down to something that then doesn't distort. And this is done within the software. We also have the master gain here. So this is another master level within the software. You, 9 times out of 10, just leave that at the 12 o'clock position and it should never distort at there. But if you see reds showing up at the top, then bring that master level down so it's not distorting out of the software either. Other DJ softwares may vary ever so slightly, but just be aware that you can use those trims to make sure you're not peaking the songs by hitting the reds and then distorting the song as it comes out of the main speakers.
And there you have it. Thank you so much for watching. Just remember that it takes a bit of trial and error when starting. You're not going to get it right every time and every mix. So just always use your ears, listen to what's coming out of the speakers, and just check those levels with the VU meters and try and compare them to what you're hearing. Trust your ears, trust what you're doing. The more you do it, the better you'll become and the more natural it will become. So make sure you play around with those trim controls or gain controls, the channel levels, and try and get a nice clean balance throughout the mix. If you want to learn how to take your skills further, or you're just getting started and want way more in-depth tutorials, then please check out our online DJ courses over on our website, wearecrossfader.co.uk. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in another tutorial very soon.